This is how Lara does it.
Hello, it's Jamie Sparks here. I am in my car in Scotland. Why am I in my car, you ask? Well, I'm on a mission to raise £5,000 for the people of Ukraine. If you want more information on that, you can hit the link below. Part of the journey for this is I'm going to be doing a YouTube series each month where I'm going to release a new video called Becoming the Tomb Raider. Hit subscribe to be kept up to date with the latest videos as they come out and ring the notification bell. I have effectively accidentally made myself Lara Croft over the past few months and years because I've accidentally kind of like learned all these different life skills. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to teach my friends these life skills as well. Some of whom have never done these types of things before, like climbing, wilderness survival, trail hiking, caving, that might be coming up later on in the year. But today's video is gonna be quintessentially Lara. It's gonna be archery. I'm here today with my friend Jason. So Jason, we are gonna go and do archery in the woods. You look excited and also kind of like a bit nervous.
I'm going to be murdered.
No murdering shall happen unless you don't aim at the target. Please just aim at the target. Thank you so much. You've done archery before, right?
Yes, like 10, 15 years ago in Canada.
Amazing. Okay. And then...
Say 10, 15 years old. God, Canada's like 20 years ago.
Okay, so 20 years ago. And then in terms of like video games, if you play video games, do you ever do kind of shooting video games?
I'm really good at the shooting video games.
Are you?
Yeah.
Okay, this will be interesting because it could go one of two ways, because you'll either be super accurate or you'll be good at grouping the arrows. So we'll see how we go, and we might even do a wee bit of hiking as well. Let's do it. We're here. Woo. Yeah, look at you.
I know.
Jason's got the bow, we're good to go. So we're in Lockerwood Community Woodland in Scotland, sidebar. And it's just a few, well, it's like a mile away from Lady Muir Plantation, I guess, under a mile, which is where they grow trees for cutting down for things, sustainable wood things. I don't know, paper, maybe, I guess. This woodland area, it's super cute. I come here quite regularly to do trail running, a little bit of light hiking, and also archery. Yeah, let's do it. Wait till you see how weird this is. This is literally us going into a horror movie. I promise I'm not gonna murder you, Jason.
Yay!
But look how strange this is. So first of all, how super old are these trees? But also, this must be some sort... Oh, it's a wee mushroom. This must be some sort of, like, old pagan ritual area. Because, like, the trees are eerily planted in a circle, which is kind of strange. So, I don't know. I get kind of Blair Witch vibes.
This would be a perfect place to camp, though.
Well... It's funny you say that, because wilderness survival is on the cards. So this is where we're going to do some archery. But I've just noticed, super exciting, there's a beehive.
Perfect.
Or a wasp nest, maybe? One of the two. So... things might get a bit waspy. So Jason's just nipped back to the car to pick up a vital piece of equipment that we forgot. So I'm just hanging out in the woods on my own. But yeah, this little community woodland has a special place in my heart because over the past few years, kind of ever since I came back from America, I came here regularly to do trail running, hiking, on the outskirts of it, a bit of climbing as well. So that's why I feel super lucky a lot of the time to live in Scotland, because there's so many places where I can do these things near. It was interesting during lockdown though, because this little community woodlands that only a few dog walkers and me knew about suddenly became like a go-to destination, which is weird. So, but I think it's cool that more people are aware of it now, but it's definitely changed. Like, a lot more people come here regularly, but it's still a nice wee area. So we're going to do some archery in a wee second, and then we're also going to go for a very short hike. I say hike, kind of like a walk. I'll show you some of the sites. Stage one, safety equipment. So let's do the super fun disclaimer part of the video. So don't do this at home. Only do archery with a trained person. Do it in a safe manner. Study all the kind of local laws and restrictions regarding this as well. Have a target and use safety equipment as well, which we're going to do. I am a formally accredited archery instructor for American archery, so I've got a good kind of ground knowledge of it all. So don't be shooting your local cat is what I'm trying to say. Be wise, make good life decisions. Effectively,
go for the rabbit.
No, don't do the rabbit. So this will probably be a montage sequence where we put this on. Yeah, perfect. Okay, arm guard, we are good to go. And then all important, safety goggles. Nerds with glasses, yay. Stage two, prepare your target. Okay, so what I'm not going to do is do a tutorial on how to do archery. That's not what this video is. No, no, no. I'm not going to tell you how to do it. I'm going to tell Jason how to do it.
Well, I'm doing this.
So if you're interested in learning how to do archery, join your local archery club or go to summer camp where you'll be trained by people who are professionals. That is my top tip to you. Right, Jason. Last time you did archery was 20 years ago.
Yes.
Are you ready?
Sure.
Let's do it. I'm going to show you how to do it. Oh, yes!
I'm not sure if you can see that, but that is yellow.
Yellow on yellow, baby.
Clipper. Great done.
No pressure. Do it. Pure do it. Shoot the target. Insert awesome music. Oh my god.
I was trying to clump.
To clump?
Yeah.
Clump it together.
Yeah, clump it together.
Yeah, do three fingers. We like three fingers. Oh hell yeah. How was that, Jason?
Sorry, I missed.
Oh no. we'll make it a bit tighter. But look how good you did. How good is that? Look at that. It's not bad at all. So you got 3 out of 4, right?
Yes.
Hell yeah. Not bad at all.
So do you aim with one eye or you...
You say that like I was aiming.
Was it even aiming? Oh my god. You're bad.
Yeah, I'm here like arrow general area.
Okay, that's what I'm going to try doing. Well, I think we're both are not going far away from the target, which is always a good thing, right?
Yes, we don't need to worry about losing an arrow.
But so far though, Jason's grouping has been better and your T-pose is better. I'm annoyed.
No, my grouping was terrible.
This is exciting though, because like here's me trying to teach you Lara Croft skills and you are already Lara Croft.
Can't do parkour.
Parkour. So this isn't something Lara Croft would do. However, it's fun.
Okay, we're gonna go for red this time. Ready for it?
Yeah.
Red. Oh, my arm's wobbling. Oh! I bet I don't get any of them. Green. I am missing them all.
Oh. Yes!
Down.
Love it.
Final part of the day. Hi. Going for a hike. Ooh. It's beautiful. Scotland. Thanks for watching this month's episode of Becoming the Tomb Raider. Hey, I'm supposed to be the archery instructor, but Jason's better than me. What can I say? I guess my friends are becoming Tomb Raiders, after all. There's loads coming up in the next few months. Loads more adventures, wilderness survival, caving, all kinds of things. If you have any suggestions for adventures that we can go on, leave a comment below. Don't forget to hit subscribe. And also ring the bell notification for notifications as to when the latest episode is coming. Don't forget, if you want to donate to our fundraiser for the people of Ukraine, you can do so in the link below. I do weekly Let's Plays. Listen to the Don't Date Me podcast. I guess that's everything. Stay blessed. Bye. Control. Taking off your clothes. No one has to know. Let me jump your balls. I need you to know that Jason is clearly lying. He's like, oh, I did this 20 years ago. He is literally hitting the target, like, square on it. So he is a liar. He's a filthy liar. Don't listen to him. He's done it before.
I'm trying to group them.